This is really about to be a masterpiece. Freddie, Gibbs, and the Alchemist have released Alfredo. It is May 29th, 2020. I could not wait any longer. I was going to wait until my car got out of the shop, or my mom's car got out of the shop, so I'd have the best speakers possible for this reaction. But I don't know how much longer the car is going to be in the shop, so we're just going to listen to this now. And I'm going to try to make this short and sweet. But I said in the last video of the single they dropped for this album, Freddie Gibbs is my favorite rapper. So I'm kind of through the roof right now, even though it might not be super evident. Once again, I just woke up and it's 3 p.m. Quarantine, bro. But I've heard the first song, 1985. So let's listen to the second song, God is Perfect. I've never been more ready for anything in my life.
Wait, what?
I'm sorry. I don't know. I know why I paused, but I don't know what to say. I don't know what to say. I don't know. If y'all heard that, if y'all got ears anything like mine, hopefully not as big, then y'all are freaking out too. Who switches flows that effortlessly, man? It's like, what is that doing? Who does that effortlessly? It's like a hot knife through butter, the way he transitions from flow to flow. Another flow. That's the hook. The microphone check. 1, 2, mic check. I pray to Mecca. All this gang shit in my brain. I got the right gun to mic check. Still back that blood out of the phone. I pray to Mecca. All this gang bitch. I be talking that shit like I'm bulletproof. Fucking DM, I'm sending the killers to. I be fucking with the G's, Chris Bloods, BDs. Man, it shouldn't aim that shit. A nigga might get gangland hit. The east side is saying that shit. The bitch can aim. I'm really trying to listen to what he's saying right now. Fuck nigga, microphone check. 1, 2, mic check. I love that faint piano. What is that?
What feeling is that creating, you know?
So, with these two instrumentals I've heard so far, the Alchemist is not, I don't know, he's not punching under his weight by any stretch of the imagination. And he's not, like, disappointing in comparison to the Madlib. Okay, that was God is Perfect. I enjoy that song, if y'all couldn't tell. I just want to keep listening to the album. So Scotty Beam featuring Rick Ross. Man, this is what I love. Okay, so you hear that instrumental right now? Doesn't it sound like some foyer music? Elevator music? Hotel lobby? But like, so beats like that, right? Like foyer shit. And then he starts rapping about his, I'm assuming his general subject matter of a criminal lifestyle over this beat that's so, you know, that it's such a distinct juxtaposition, is what I'm trying to say. Like on the West Side Gun song, like on the intro to his last album, I forget, the No Vacancy, it's also like a foyer ass beat, and you know, he's rapping what West Side Gun talks about, coke, and I remember he says,
I blow your brains out in broad daylight.
That was not a good impression, but y'all know what, well, y'all might not know what West Side Gun sounds like, but if y'all haven't checked out West Side Gun, check him out. Rick Ross always kills features, bro. One of my favorite features ever is a Rick Ross feature from, you know, Kanye's Devil in the Dress. Your execution will be televised. He's used this flow before. Fuck generation, bitch. Fuck generation, bitch. This generation genocide. He said something like that. Don't cross me like Isaiah. That should be ill-advised me. I do murder bare-face. Don't need no mask to disguise me. Okay, he's talking. He's talking right now. My effing in the stash. I think the crackers behind me. Hey, he pulled me over. I asked him, yo, what's the problem, sir? I swear to duck the potholes. Man, I had no option, sir. Oh, I remember on 1985, he said some line about beat me up, Scotty, on the first song, and now it's called Scotty Bean. Just let me go, because my license insurance proper, sir. I hate to be on the rubber smoking the officer. You bustin' ones always be leaving us. Caught up in the moment, most niggas. It hurt to say I miss you. The real ones always be leaving us. I think it was him that had the line, the good die young, OGs 30 and up. I feel like I'm definitely wrong on that, though. I guess that's kind of a simple line. Maybe I'm wrong, but you know, that's, Freddie's good at that. He's good at doing lines that come off maybe just surface level, and maybe they are, but it's like, it's just what they mean, even at the surface level, just can be elevated so much. It's like, he can say a lot by saying a little type of deal. Has to be your own damn homies. Judas said Jesus up. Erotic dreams. Fucking hell of thoughts, but I really want me and Scotty Beam. Shit was different when Mike left, and it was Scotty team. X won't take me back without me, the bitch wouldn't have got a ring. Real father right here, yo. Some joke another bitch, you know the lines. When you write your raps, until the penitentiary just 400 seconds. This is also a familiar flow from Rick Ross. But I'm not tired of it by any means. I had a vision back when I was fishing for a bass, but they won't listen to you in your kitchen count cash. I got the dollars, motherfucker, nigga, credit scope. Big bag of chronic like I'm sacking up at Interscope. My pistol polish. Like I'm sacking up at Interscope. Was it the chronic released by Interscope Records or something? The Dr. Dre record? Any problems, I'm gonna pull it out. Peter Parker, but I've yet to remember, I'm young. I haven't even listened to The Chronic. Don't fight me. Bitches looking at me, shawty wanna see my soul. I never bring them home. She's just out. Oh. I mean, he brings him back to his place. Didn't Rick Ross have that questionable last line? That's not funny. About slip something in the drink, she won't even know what happened, you know, something like that. Yeah. Anyway. I ride a slip of panties off. He wanted war until they hit him with a cannonball. Yes. Kobe Bryant when we speak your very best. I pray for Gigi Wonder if she'll get to see me next. That was a cool song. Again, I don't know what to say about it. I guess I'll just keep this shit playing. Next song. Look at me. Look at me. Look at me. Shut up, brother. That's Alchemist, all right. While the nigga wrist reckless, ho was tripping, never one less bitch, ho. Yeah. Take a look at me, bitch. Yeah. 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 Look at me, motherfucker, look at me. And my bitch got a tax check back, she gon' put a real nigga back on this beat. We bees on my seat. What the fuck would you heard when I ride in the... I ain't looking back. He's a madman. Yeah. This is all I'm asking for, man. This is just for real. This is like the epitome of my kind of music, bro. I'm loving this. Take a look at me. Oh no. Okay, we're at the Benny the Butcher song. Frank Lucas featuring Benny the Butcher. Benny the Butcher is another one of my favorite rappers. Griselda is one of my favorite record labels working today. I've always wanted Freddie Gibbs and Benny to work together, man. I feel like they should have already, but I feel like I'm pretty sure they haven't. If I'm wrong, tell me, but they're about to mesh so well. What are they about to rap over? My name is Cocaine. Yeah. 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 Okay. I'm okay with that. Pause. I'm sorry. That was just an overwhelming amount of heat for a moment there. Okay. He's literally switching up the flow like every two bars. I'ma run that back. That verse. Kerosene and ashes, don't get carried away. I've been up, and look how carefully I stack it. Got your advance check buried in the mattress. We the Yankees on a pennant run. You need a soldiers, I heard you renting some. Telling war stories and you ain't been in none. But look what I converted to. From letting burners loose out convertibles. My bitch gon' be the driver for a purse or two. Nah, my finger never could point. You know pussy best when it's moist. Got a hammer and a brick in. I got head and a Royce. We chasing cheddar, of course. I wouldn't care if it's Deutsch. It was either never took an L, but a few lost a mind. New law of downtown, and this view was hard to find. Sold lines to abusers, now abuse y'all with lines. I mean, it's black thing. Wow. Sold lines to abusers, now abuse y'all with lines. I mean, you know, I've probably heard something like that before, but
he just a few cars behind. I bought two of everything. They said dude lost his mind. Fuck two whips, one a coupe that's too small to drive.
The bro, the wordplay on two.
Two car garage, two broad massage.
I mean, I don't know if that's considered wordplay. It's, you know, I know this isn't like a novel, but it's kind of like a motif, you know. If you're just saying, you know what I mean? I don't know. Not a motif. Forget it.
Got from the district. They say hustling like a disease. I'ma die with the symptoms. Put 300 grams on the brick, cut the pie in the sixes.
They say hustling like a disease. I'ma die with the symptoms. Is that what he said, bro? Well, what was the last line? I have no complaints with that, man. No complaints.
Make no mistake, girl, I still love you.
No complaints. Okay. So I was really hyped to hear this album. So I already listened to the Tyler Creator song. I forgot to tell y'all that at the start. And, I mean, I think that's okay, because it's a pretty chill song anyway, so my reaction would not be that riveting. Play a little of it. Yeah, they're great. This would be great, like, rainy day music. It reminds me of the other Tyler the Creator feature on Westside Gunn's album. The 327 song. Sounds kind of similar. Just vibe-wise. I miss rapping as Tyler, bro. Because, you know, Igor was just a pop record straight up. And we all know Tyler can spit when he wants to. You ain't got it figured out. He goes on for a minute in this song. Like cotton on some basic shit is off. We ain't a J. Oh, my afro long, I pick it out like cotton. I don't know if he like finishes that whole. And I'm grounded like the pavement. We ain't linking like the bracelet, bro. Better get your wrist. We ain't linking like the bracelet broke? Is he talking about handcuffs? Is that a stretch? I don't know.
Next song is Baby Shit.
Ain't nobody ever gave me shit. I had to take this shit, go get your paper.
Oh. I heard this too on Freddie Gibbs and the Alchemist went live on Instagram last night, and I watched it, and they just played this song, and this is all I heard. This song is all I heard. Other than that Tyler Creator song, but they didn't play that. So I heard this once, but it was like, you know, it was really low quality. So basically the first one. Like, syllables just line up perfectly with the drums and shit. Or just at least like any like accent on the beat. Like he accents his vocals right where the beat has an accent too. And so it just has this punchy feeling, you know what I'm saying? I fuck with that line. Wait, like, he said something about, like, Versace robe looking like a cape, but I can't save it.
He said the line, like, three lines before this. I just didn't realize until now.
Very bad. Cool. Baby Shit. Baby Shit was a bop. It definitely had some lines in there. That shit's going on the playlist. All this shit is going on the playlist. Next, we got the Conway the Machine feature. The song's called Babies and Fools. Conway the Machine is also on Griselda. Him and Benny are like cousins or brothers or something. Let's go. Yeah. It's gonna be hard. You know, you hear that, the way that came in, bro? Dum, 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 dum. Is that how it went? Yeah. Can't you?
My second love was hard drugs, weed, and this rapping shit. Under the lounge, the nights that I wasn't having shit. I say my prayers, but I'm rusty as fuck with Arabic. Lord, take me as I am, cause I'm gonna come as I'm is. In tears, I gave up. I ain't gonna never die.
I love when people use samples to replace lyrics.
I did the fooling with this tool to put my babies through school. I took my lasso out the country, fuck that bitch, we ain't cool. First love is writing verses and rapping bars. My second love is sitting on bandals and trapped in arms. Hospital bed, bullet in my neck and a fractured jaw.
Yeah, so Conway, he's got a thing called cerebral palsy. And I don't know if that came from when he got shot in the head. But yeah, it's like when, you know, one side of his face is like kind of paralyzed in this position. So I don't know if that, you know, I'm assuming that happened after he got shot. Yeah, I think that happened after he got shot in the head. Because he's rapped, you know, he's rapped about it a good amount. Yeah. Y'all should listen to The Cow by Westside Gunn. Conway has a crazy verse on there.
Stacks every now and then, like that's enough. She like at least FaceTime, your baby don't see your ass enough. Plus my oldest son is spelling math, that shit ain't adding up. I guess I ain't around being a dad enough, I owe my kids.
My oldest son is failing math, that shit ain't adding up. That's kind of,
I owe the mind and by a lake, the shots dispersed from this lot. I gave my head.
That's great.
That's a fact, man.
That's great. That's crazy. All right, penultimate song, Skinny Shug. Skinny Shug. Is that Freddie?
Obviously.
What's business, man? I never take it personally. Skinny black nigga, rich off rap, sweat promoters, ain't got the dope for that. He lost and sent me back, man. I'm literally selling dope to rap. I can't.
This is a weird beat. Let me get through this whole song. Damn. Imagine that, bro. He said, I think he said his uncle had an overdose, and Freddie said he knew the guys who sold him.
Pistol to my head, I was way too scared, drunk off emotion. I'm drinking and taking these drugs, cause I can't numb the pain with smoke. Locked up, she might just fuck.
I don't know, I really like this. I really, really like this, actually. Again, it's just hitting, getting stuff off his chest, and it comes off kind of simple. Some of these lines are kind of simple, and, like, it's kind of... I mean, generally, you do know what to expect with Freddie Gibbs, I guess. But this is more, like, fly talk than I expected, I guess. I mean, I guess he does do fly talk, but... He generally balances between the street shit and the fly talk. And, I mean, I guess he's doing a good balance right now, but it just seems like there's more fly talk than usual. Like what Griselda does. Griselda does a great mix of fly shit and street shit. Most niggas die over love for a bitch or having trust in their homies. A skinny black... We're on to the last song on the record. It's called All Glass. Only 2.5 minutes long. I'm glad this shit was 10 tracks. That's good. That's a really good length. Money in the church pot. Your nephew worked for me, got bundles in his church socks. Big bunny rabbit, I drop a package, my youngest down the slide. Shut up your Escalade, I bought them all, PlayStation 5. They hold you for 3 days if you were suspect for a recent murder. You could do the Tina Turner, Kyrie Irving. Uncle Fred had you shot to the head. Better get that boy to the face, get your wife to your baby shower. Outside is the army. There's a lot going on in the beat right now. You and Navy Power, what's up, bitch? Okay, it's like an organ in the back. That's what that is. And he says Sunday service. Treat her like an under 3,000. Fuck with Caroline. Fuck with Caroline. I mean, I know the song. Roses by Outkast.
Caroline.
That's probably a good ass bar, but I don't fully understand it. These snakes moving in tall grass. Fall till I fall, never pass the ball with my ball down. Aaron Hall fucking these hoes, don't need no hall pass. Straight drop, straddle. I think the Alchemist is bald too, right? So. And it was all glass, all glass. Interesting. I don't know how much I love the mix on that instrumental. That might just be me. I feel like that could have been mixed better. Okay. Alfredo by Freddie Gibbs and the Alchemist. This shit is an 8. An 8 out of 10. It could be a 9, but Bandana is a 9, and this doesn't quite touch Bandana.
By the way, this is off of First Reaction. I obviously need to listen to the album a lot more to get a real feel for what the score will be, but off my initial thoughts, it's an 8.
And Pinata for me is a 10. 10 songs, 35 minutes. Alfredo, I love that idea. I said in my last video, but you know, Alfred Alchemist and Fredo for Freddy. What are my favorite songs, man? Every song. My absolute favorite songs are probably the second track, God is Perfect, Babies and Fools, and like Frank Lucas and Baby Shit. Yeah, and 1985 is hard too. And Skinny Shook. okay. Man, that's great. That's, again, I mean, I said it before. That's all I can ask for from a Freddie Gibbs and Alchemist project, basically. And also, like I said before, that epitomizes my music taste, practically. At least that's, like, my favorite type of hip-hop right there. So I'm happy. wow. And, yeah, man, Freddie just does it like nobody else. The Alchemist does it like nobody else. They need to drop more tapes, for sure. But anyway, y'all. It's been Love. It's been Robbie the Reactor. Let me know what y'all think of the album down
below.
Don't forget to
subscribe.
I'm at 65 subscribers, which is crazy. I only have a handful of videos out, but before my first video, I had like 15 or something. I got 65. I'd say it's a pretty solid improvement. So, it's pretty cool for me. Anyway. Yeah, let me know what y'all thought. The record. Did you love it? Did you hate it? What would you rate it? Let me stop. And yeah, love y'all. That was great. And I'll smell you later.